Narragansett, those flags are just blowing like crazy. What are we looking at for wind gusts today, Michelle?
Well, some of them will be gusting over 40 miles per hour. On the high end, we could get a couple of gusts that approach 50 miles per hour. So that's why we're under a wind advisory for the daytime today. Here's another wider view of our Narragansett camera. And you can see we're back to some sunshine, and we'll see more sun than clouds through the daytime. North Scituate at dry roadways, and yeah, the flags there are blowing. We'll talk more about those current wind speeds, but I do want to show you that we're back to dry skies on our live Doppler radar. We widen out the view some. Some rain and snow showers and flurries have been breaking out over western New England. These are going to be diminishing through the daytime, and I don't expect us to see any additional measurable rain today, even tomorrow and through the rest of the week. So we did pick up some beneficial amounts yesterday, about 3/4 of an inch in Providence, over an inch in Westerly, and about 0.7 of an inch of rain in Smithfield. Now back to dry skies and chilly air settling in. 40 currently in Taunton, 39 in Providence, 37 in Smithfield. We'll lead our three key things with those chilly winds. It's a drier week ahead and eventually turning milder. The winds are picking up now, so we're seeing those sustained winds at about 20 miles per hour and gusts between 25 and 35 miles per hour at times. The strongest winds are expected from the late morning into the afternoon hours, and that's why we're under a wind advisory. I mentioned the potential for some of those gusts 40 to 50 miles per hour. So here, as we head into the end of the morning, the wind's going to continue to strengthen, and at lunchtime, some gusts 43 in Providence, 45 Taunton, 46 in Smithfield, close to 50 on Block Island. It's not going to cause widespread damage, but with still some leaves on some of the trees, we could certainly get some isolated damage and outages. 5 o'clock this evening, the strongest winds have passed by already, and we'll be seeing some diminishing wind speeds through the later evening and nighttime hours. This morning, temperature is not going to change much. Lower 40s, 10 a.m., right around 40 degrees at lunchtime today, and we'll hover around those upper 30s to low 40s into the afternoon, too, as the sun goes down. Before 5 o'clock this evening, we're expecting the temperatures to already be in the 30s. So 36 at 6 o'clock in the evening, going to feel like winter. When you add in the winds, wind chill in the afternoon and evening, middle and upper 20s. Here's a look at the forecast for tonight. So low to mid 30s for an overnight low. The temperatures actually rise a few degrees as the night goes on. Clouds will be on the increase. We could get a sprinkle or a flurry ahead of our next frontal system. So early in the night, middle 30s at 11 o'clock, and then rising up into the upper 30s to near 40 by 7 o'clock in the morning. So a little bit of precipitation and cloud cover that you see here when you wake up tomorrow morning, and just a sprinkle or a flurry that'll clear out, and we'll end the day with brighter skies for your election day weather. So just a weak front coming through, nothing that would cause significant issues for people trying to get to the polls. So let's take a look at the tropical satellite here. We've got a Hurricane Eta going to be approaching the Nicaraguan coastline. As it moves over land, it'll gradually weaken, but could become a strong Category 2 before landfall tomorrow. 7-day forecast. It's a quiet week with just the temperatures again going to be cool to start, but then by Wednesday afternoon, starting to turn those temperatures up. 50s for highs Wednesday, then 60s Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. We could be up into the upper 60s in spots.